Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. So in today's video we are going to continue the topic which is activity 4.6. So we have experimented the activity. Now here's an explanation of this. So is there a difference in the way metals and non-metals react with acids? What could the pop sound in some cases be due to when a burning matchstick is brought near the mouth of the test tubes? You must have found that non-metals generally do not react with acids, but metals react with acids and produce hydrogen gas that burns with a pop sound. So underline these points, it's very important. So you must have noticed that copper does not react with dilute hydrochloric acid even on heating, but it reacts with sulfuric acid. So that's it for this activity, and now we are going to continue with this D point, that is reactions with bases. So here's an activity given for this. So here's an activity 4.7. then we have, during the preparation of sodium hydroxide solution, care should be taken that pellets of sodium hydroxide are handled with a plastic spatula. So there is a precaution given here. Then we have to prepare a fresh solution of sodium hydroxide in a test tube by dissolving 3 to 4 pellets of it in 5 ml of water. Drop a piece of aluminium foil into it. Bring a burning matchstick near the mouth of the test tube. Observe carefully. So we have to prepare a fresh solution of sodium hydroxide in a test tube, and we have to dissolve 3 to 4 pellets of it in 5 ml of water. Pellets means small chunk of matter. Then we have to drop a piece of aluminium foil into it. Then bring a burning matchstick near the mouth of the test tube, and we have to observe this very carefully. So then what does the pop sound indicate? As before, the pop sound indicates the presence of hydrogen gas. So we have to keep this point in mind. Then metals react with the sodium hydroxide to produce hydrogen gas. Reactions of non-metals with bases are complex. So here are three points you have to keep in mind, that is, what does the pop sound indicate and its answer. Then metals react with sodium hydroxide to produce hydrogen gas. Then the last one, which is reactions of non-metals with bases are complex. So keep these points underlined, and you have to continue this with reading the activity 4.7. Then you can understand all these points. Then we have the next topic, which is point E, displacement reactions. So we will continue this in the next video.